Previously on Game of Thrones.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. He knows all your weaknesses, all your plans, because you have a traitor in your council. He's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing.
We were told we'd be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's enough, Andros.
Northgrove. That's just some shit story for little kids.
I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about. I'm part of the Free Folk. People round here call wildlings.
My true name is Sarah. Flowers.
You're a bastard?
It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore? You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
I'm sorry. I'm going to tell Father the betrothal is off.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot.
Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
If you presume to speak of my dragons, you best choose your words carefully.
Vesca!
Are you gonna be a good little forester? Learn your lesson? And stay down!
Don't think this is over, Roderick!
The foresters need to keep their end. End of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward. Kill him if they give you any trouble.
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig.
I knew you were a killer the day you arrived. Seems Britt found out too. Now they all see it. What sort of brother you really are.
Britt was the killer, and worse. He got what was coming to him.
And you made sure he got it, didn't you? Threw him clear off the wall. You told me what you did to get here. We both know you had blood on your hands. But now, you've killed one of your brothers. You'll lose your head for this, Tuttle. You'll be disgraced, dishonored, and burned till there's nothing left of you.
You won't execute me. With Mance Rayder coming, the Night's Watch needs all the men it can get.
Honest men. Loyal men. Not brother killers. There's only one thing to be done with you now.
Hey, Frostfinger. I saw what Garrett did to Britt last night. I was there. My relief was late, so I stayed behind. I saw everything.
Yeah, he was there.
Then go on. What did you see, boy?
It wasn't Garrett's fault. We were on watch when Brit just attacked him. Garrett had no choice but to fight back.
There isn't a man at the wall wouldn't sell his own mother for the right price. You two are up to something. Some deal you worked out. Or he's defending you for some reason I can't fathom.
That's impossible. Finn can't stand me. Because you're a fucking squire who thinks you're better than everyone.
Enough! Garrett killed the man of the watch. There's a price to be paid for that. Let's go. I knew it was a mistake to make you a ranger.
Crossfinger. What's to be done with him? We're heading to Crusted.
You'll have to find someone else for your expedition. Your man here still has a lot to answer for. Now out of the way, Snow.
Give us a moment.
Then kiss him quick and be done with it.
Garrett. I know you said you couldn't promise anything, but this... What happened? I thought you were smarter than that, Garrett. I thought you were going to be by my side at Craster's.
I know I did the right thing. That's all that matters.
What Brit did to your family... Anyone would want him dead. But now you'll have to face the consequences.
But John...
I'm sorry, Garrett. There's nothing more I can do.
We're down a man, so keep your eyes open. Now let's move.
Seems even your mother's abandoned you. Won't be alone for long, though. The Axeman will find you soon enough.
Do you know how many men have stood before me with false tales of my dragons? Desperate men, hoping for wealth, protection. Liars, every one of them. And I expect you are no different. You don't want to see what I do to liars.
I wouldn't lie to you. You have my word.
Your word means nothing. Not when it is so easily bought.
Oh, shit.
Are you frightened? I thought you'd seen a dragon before. Your reaction says otherwise. Viseron.
He's much smaller than the other one.
Would you like to touch him? Go ahead. Unless you are afraid. Of course, a man who has really faced a dragon before may have reason to be afraid. Go on.
Not a good idea, sir.
I don't think he likes me.
Then you were wise to keep your distance. You claim you saw Drogon. Give me a reason to believe you. I told you I've heard this story before. I'm going to need more than that.
You're asking for proof.
I have this.
Drogon, how did you get that? What have you done to him? If you've hurt him...
Hurt him?
He attacked us.
Drogon wouldn't strike without reason. You must have scared him. He is not some kind of thoughtless beast. He's only a child.
Oh, a child who can breathe fire on whoever he likes.
The men who are following us, the Lost Legion, they drew their swords and tried to fight him.
And Drogon defended himself.
So we somehow deserve to be burnt alive because your little baby was scared.
Your tongue is dangerously sharp, sellsword. Why did you come here? You offer me nothing but lies. To what end? You want gold? A title? My undying gratitude? What do you want from me, Asher Forrester?
My little brother was murdered in front of his family, and our youngest is still held against his will at our enemy's house.
What is it you expect me to do?
We need to hire an army.
An army?
If you could spare some of your sellswords.
Please, if...
I also came here looking for an army. But what I found were the cries of children and people suffering in chains while their masters profited from their misery. My sellswords will help me free the slaves of Meereen. That is their mission. Your need is not greater than theirs. These are people who have suffered for years without end.
We both want the same thing here. To liberate Meereen, to see you take the Iron Throne. That's what I want too.
If you really believe that, you'll understand why I cannot help you.
There must be something I can do to convince you.
As we speak, my men prepare to enter Meereen. What they are about to do is much bigger than you or I. Bigger than one family back in Westeros. So, unless you think you can storm Meereen and free all the slaves yourself...
You have nothing more to offer me, Croft. You may leave.
That's
but
it.
Your grace.
See them out.
I faced a dragon and lived. Nothing in Meereen can be worse than that.
How bold of you. You forget that is my dragon you boast of defeating.
I said I survived, nothing more.
And Beskar here, she has a history in Meereen. She could help guide us.
What the hell?
Is this true?
Yes. I lived in Meereen for a time. On the eastern side of the city. Fucking bastard.
So you wish to accompany them? You'd help the Second Sons? Guide them into Meereen?
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Is that what you're saying?
You're really considering this?
They could prove valuable.
Asha, please.
I can only speak for myself. I'll go alone.
She's the one who knows the city. She will accompany you. Or you won't be going at all.
I believe that's more than fair. You two will join Croft and his men. Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded. But your uncle stays here. If I find you've lied or put my men in danger...
I understand.
Good. Croft will get you settled in. It's going to be a long night.
Are we really going into Meereen?
What's the problem with you and Meereen anyway?
Doesn't matter now, does it?
Beskar.
Get your armor patched up in here. Extra bedrolls if you need them. Piss buckets in the corner where it's always fucking been.
Long time since we had a piss bucket.
I spent 2 years trying to get where I am now. Don't fuck this up for me, Asher.
Nail! We got two more.
Curse his bloody leg!
It's not your leg that's a problem, Roderick. You've got to be practical. You got the best of Griff last time. When he comes looking for revenge, do you think you can beat him?
He'll be angry, looking for revenge.
It sounds like you'd prefer if Roderick stayed down in the mud.
Next time I face Griff, it will be the last. I won't let him parade around my halls any longer.
I look forward to it, my lord. But you won't win a fair fight.
You can't handle a sword like you used to. So find another advantage. Surprise your opponent. Do something unexpected.
Like what?
I'll show you. Come at me.
Bring your opponent down to your level.
When I attack you, drop down, avoid my blade, and swing at the back of my knees. Wait for me to attack.
Roderick!
Let's try it again.
Almost.
Again.
Now that's how you do it.
I think you let me. Oh.
My lord. Sorry to interrupt.
Lena?
She insisted on seeing you immediately.
Lady Elena, I'm sorry to hear we won't be sisters.
Talia. Roderick. Can I speak with you? Privately. You remember my little brother?
Quiver! Good gods, you've grown.
You could just call me Arthur now.
I hope you don't mind us coming unannounced. But something's happened. I didn't know what else to do. Maybe this was a bad idea.
I've missed you, Elena.
I've missed you too. Truth be told, you're the only one I can turn to. Lord Whitehill paid my father a visit at Rillwater Crossing. He told my father you were disobeying Griff's authority and...
And he wanted to teach you a lesson.
As if I'm some token to be handed around.
You mean?
He demanded I marry his son, Griff.
What?
Lud threatened my family. Told my father if he refused, we'd be slaughtered along with you.
Father acted the damn coward.
He agreed, Roderick. I am to marry Griff Whitehill. That arrogant, pig-eyed prick!
I still can't believe Father agreed to it.
You can't marry into House Whitehill. We'll end up on opposite sides of a war.
Do you think I want to marry that disgusting pig? But my father won't listen. I'm not going to be the bone they throw that howling dog. I'm not going to be some prize for him to rip open. We have to get rid of him. I can't think of any other way. My father won't see reason. Lord Whitehill's made up his mind.
It's time someone brought Griff down.
We were hoping you'd say that.
You brought your men.
I command Father's elite guard. These men are trained archers, swordsmen, experts in both ranged and close combat. They're yours, if you'll help us take down Griff.
The whole guard?
20 men. My father still thinks they're aboard a ship bound for the Reach. What do you have to lose, Roderick? Griff has been a nightmare for you and your house.
You can't have any reason to keep him around.
This could help both of us.
I have to decide what's best for my house.
I know that. I know this might sound mad, but it's the only way. Get rid of Griff, and you'll be free to use the guard however you like. You can finally take control of your house again. Please, promise me you'll do this. I love you, Roderick. I don't want Griff. I don't want any of this.
I would be happy to.
Thank you, Roderick.
Griff won't even see it coming. My men are yours to command.
Thank you, Quip. Arthur.
Could you give us a moment? You don't know how much this means to me. I'm sorry I couldn't marry you before. Maybe when this is all over, we could play hide and seek in the grove again. Pretend we're still children. Forget all that's happened these last few years.
I'd like that very much, Elena.
Then you know where to find me.
We should go.
Yes. You're right. Arthur will be waiting for us.
I can't believe it's another coronation already. Our kings just get younger and younger.
Tommen's not ready. He's too soft.
Maybe that was the imp's plan.
I wonder if Marjorie Tyrell will be there today.
You mean Queen Marjorie? She was married to Joffrey.
For all of 1 hour.
She'll marry his brother too. Not to mention Cersei and Jaime. The Lannisters have spies everywhere.
What is it, Tom?
Remember that warning you'd heard from Roderick?
About Whitehill's contact. Did you find anything?
Only whispers. But your brother's right. Lord Whitehill. Lord Whitehill is sending a great deal of gold to someone here in King's Landing. He's definitely up to something. Something big. But I don't know what.
Well done, Tom. Did you hear anything else?
Lord Whitehill is surprisingly secretive. The only people I'm even certain he deals with are those Ironwood merchants. They'll both be at the feast after Tommen's coronation today. Maybe you can learn something.
I can't go. She's not exactly happy with me right now. I've been uninvited.
Couldn't Sarah help? Ask her to get you in. She'd do it, right? Don't handmaidens look out for each other?
I think I can convince her. I know things about her that she wouldn't want told.
Time to apply a little pressure, then.
It's nearly time.
Just be careful, Lady Mira. King's Landing seems to have it in for you.
What are you doing out here? There's leftover honey cake in the kitchens.
Have to guard this one. Locked him up in the old storeroom until morning.
That the one who killed Brit? He's not going anywhere. Come on. He'll be back before anyone notices.
All right. Maybe just a quick bite. He's likely to freeze to death out here anyway.
Don't know what I expected. out there. I can't move it. Won't budge. Garrett! Cotter, what are you doing here?
I heard him talking. You're to be executed in the morning.
What about Finn? He told
them... Nobody believes him. Or don't want to. They think he's covering for you. Some are even saying he helped you do it.
I have to get out of here.
That's why I came. I want to help.
You'd be executed too. Why would you want to help me?
You had my back with Finn. He would have killed me over that knife. I figured it was about time I returned the favor. So I'm getting you out of here. I don't want to hear any complaining.
You're a good man. You know that.
Don't go singing my praises just yet. I want you to take me with you. To the North Grove. You know I can't stay here. I'm leaving Castle Black, but I'd rather not go it alone. So if you're going north, I'm coming with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere unless I can get out of this bloody storeroom first.
I can try and pick the lock, but I'm not sure it will work. It's rusted a bit inside. I can try, but it may not do any good. Can you see any other way out?
There's a loose stone over here. Can you see it?
Yeah. It's not moving, though.
Keep trying. Let me see what I can do. Not loose enough. How's it looking out there, Cotter?
Well, fine, I suppose. We have to hurry. Someone will come along soon.
Locked.
Pulling on it won't help.
This is a pretty serious door. We're not going through it.
What are you gonna do? Damn it! Bugger it all!
Probably cover it with fleas. It's rotten. This is all bloody useless. Oh, I'm not getting out that way. Must be the latrine. I'm not sticking around to use it. Onions and crab apples. At least I won't starve to death. If I ever find a way out of here. That might be useful.
What are you doing?
Getting out of here.
I can see it. It's coming loose. I'm
gonna try to push it out. You pull, all right? I hope no one heard that. Hey, can you fit through?
I think.
You two idiots, lucky I'm not Frostfinger. Thought you were being sly, eh?
I figured you'd try something like this.
It worked, didn't it?
Finn, you bastard. What are you doing here?
I'm the sword in the darkness. Help me a fellow brother keep his head. You'll need this. Now, let's go.
You're not coming with us, Finn.
What are you on about? Frostfinger already thinks I'm helping you. What do you think he's gonna do when he hears you've run off with Potato Fucker over here? I'd rather take my chances with you.
And I'm good in a fight. You know that.
Yeah, good at starting them anyway.
You'll need another blade at your side. Three's better than two.
Having another ranger along couldn't hurt.
Till he stabs you in the back.
We'll talk later. Move!
There's no turning back now. We're deserters for sure. We're breaking our vows.
I've taken plenty of oaths. Broken plenty too. Words don't mean shit.
There'll be a price on our heads. Or worse.
My family back home is counting on me to put things right. And I mean to do it. Vows aren't going to stop me.
They know we're gone now.
Then how fast can you run?
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Griff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
I'm coming.
What do you mean to do?
This could be our chance.
He's right. We must hurry before things get violent.
I'll make sure the Maester is safe. That's what matters.
Just don't forget your promise, Roderick.
The rest of my men are still in the grove.
They could be here in minutes.
I'll need every one of them for what I'm about to do.
I'll have them here as soon as possible. Let's go.
And Arthur. Listen for my signal. I'll strike my cane when I want you to enter.
We'll be ready.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe. Griff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Together, then.
Obey his new master. And while you're at it, Elena Glenmore, what are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you?
Me.
You? I'd rather marry a dead horse.
You watch your bloody tongue, or I'll give you what I'm giving the maester.
Excuse me?
Let the maester go, Griff.
Not until he's learned his lesson. He's disobedient, just like you are, Roderick. So now he's paying the price.
My hand! I'm sorry.
Don't believe you.
You'll pay for this in blood.
Still the old cocky Roderick, eh? Trying to show Elena that you'll never back down. You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
I think you need another lesson in humility. Just like your maester here.
You can watch if you like.
Go ahead. Come at me, Griff.
My fucking pleasure. You're dead, Roderick.
I doubt that.
Grab him. Don't just stand there. He is not the Lord.
What are your orders?
I'm the only one here who gives the orders! What are you waiting for? Come on, defend your lord!
Kill anyone that moves!
You heard him! Stop now! You can't do this!
Now then, about humility.
Get your hands off me!
Maester, are you all right?
Yes, I think so. My father will go straight to Roose Bolton. He'll flay you and your sister and your whole fucking family!
I did warn you, Griff.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you... Is this the man you'd rather have? This
Roderick!
Enough! That's enough! Are you satisfied?
You need to stop.
My eye!
Roderick! No! No, you can't!
Why are you protecting him?
I'm not protecting him. I'm protecting Ryan. When Lud hears of this, don't you realize what you'll do to him? If you kill Griff, Ryan will be the one to suffer.
Lord Vitiel doesn't have to find out.
You can only keep this a secret for so long. I want him dead, believe me. But not at the cost of Ryan's life. Besides, he may still be useful to us.
It's all right, Roderick.
Least I could do. Confine the White Hills to the cellars. No one gets in or out.
Word cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not until we want it to. Kill the ravens. All of them.
I swear I will!
Fuck you and your queen!
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission.
Obey?
You know what kind of shit-brained fool does that? One who wants to fucking die out there. Have you lost your damn mind?
I am not some animal in a cage.
What in the seven bloody hells are you talking about?
I will not let you bark orders at me.
I'm glad to see you two are getting along. Warms the heart.
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher.
You think I'm too drunk to fight? What the fuck
do
you know?
What are you gonna do? Run out there swinging a fucking...
Still think I can't fight?
You fucking bitch!
Oh, there we go. There's the asshole I remember.
Hey, come on, Vesca. Leave the poor man
alone. Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend. She'll get us all
you
killed.
You sound scared, Croft.
This is bloody important.
You afraid your mother will spank you?
I will not let you two fuck this up.
Are you looking forward to it?
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, we're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody show like you
Vesca,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
You gonna lecture me too?
Fuck!
Croft doesn't know shit about anything. None of you do. Fuck Croft. You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say? Your fucking uncle is the only reason I'm even here. He told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you. You get me burned by a dragon! You did this. Come on, Asher. Hit me. Oh, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead. You want to help?
I'm not going to do that! Whatever your problem is with Marine, you have to get over it!
Get over it? I was a slave! Here, in this fucking city! I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was seven, my master threw me in the fighting pit to die.
When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started sending other children. I butchered every one of them. After a while, I thought the fear was gone. I thought I was used to it.
But you had no choice.
I did. I decided my life was worth saving. But theirs were not. There was this boy. We used to play five stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. That same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly. My master watched as I did it, smiling. I could have killed him for that fucking smile.
That's enough drinking for tonight. It'll only make you feel worse.
I don't need any more men telling me what to do. I bought my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man. Marine is a city of dead children. Don't worry about me. I won't let you down.
Come on. You've had enough. Let me take that.
The news.
I have.
Let's look at the two.
You shouldn't say that.
Why not?
Mira, I'll meet you inside. What are you doing here?
I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend, but...
Then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important?
Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family. And someone in there is helping him.
Look, I can't get you in. Marjorie's already furious with you. And I'm not really interested in joining you on her bad side.
You're on your own.
Please, Sarah. I know you're probably angry with me, but I need your help.
I don't know.
Please.
Fine. But you owe me, understand? She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise. Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it? Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira, Lord Garibald Tarwick.
She's quite lovely. Where have you been hiding her?
You're making her blush. Sorry, Mira. He gets a bit carried away.
You flatter me. Sarah's lovelier than us all.
I won't argue there. It's quite a feast, isn't it? Just be careful around the wine. I hear you're partial to a particular Arbor Red. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed. Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people and...
Oh, Lord Tarwick!
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
It's clear.
Oh, really?
My ears are not delicate.
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loads.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Is there someone you'd rather be talking to?
I'm sorry, I'm rather thirsty.
Oh, allow me.
No, I can get it myself. Thank you. If you'll excuse me.
This reminds me of the tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe it.
You told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it!
Andros, you're being ridiculous!
And why would you ever stop dealing ironwood?
Is there no longer a demand for it?
I can't imagine that would be the case.
No need for such wild speculation. I've simply lost interest. I'm moving on to better things, as they say.
And what would that be?
No. I can see what you're doing. I'm not kidding.
I heard he was killed. Right here in the garden.
Well...
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Lady Mira, I'm impressed.
Impressed with what?
That you aren't currently locked in a cell. I trust this means that you took care of that contract. How did you do it, if I may ask? I wasn't expecting to see you again, if I'm being honest. You must have made quick work of it.
Wouldn't you like to know?
All right. You can keep your secrets. I do believe King's Landing is rubbing off on you.
So, what have you been up to?
Enjoying yourself?
Though I suppose if you're talking to me, you must want something. Don't tell me you just enjoy my company.
I've heard you stopped selling ironwood. Not on my account, I hope.
How did you?
So it's true.
It appears that you know most of the story already. I've been pushed out of the ironwood business.
Oh.
All thanks to my partner. Bloody imbecile. Andros is now Lud Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing. No matter the fact that I introduced them in the first place, that man would be nothing without me.
Do you know what Lord Andros is planning?
He's acquired a large amount of gold, but I haven't the slightest idea what he intends to buy with it. Whatever it is, he's managed to get a Lannister involved.
A Lannister?
Lyman. He may only be a third cousin, but he's a Lannister all the same.
Rickard! Are you done flirting with that handmaiden? We need your opinion here.
Oh, leave him alone.
Please excuse me.
And a Lannister, too.
I thought we were done talking about this.
You asked me about my friend.
Friends, yes. Lyman is your business partner.
What's the difference?
Fair enough, Andros.
And if my friend...
Excuse me.
Lyman Lannister?
Shit!
You startled me. As if I don't already have enough to deal with.
Here, let me help.
That's very kind of you, thank you. But I'm fine. I just get clumsy sometimes. I'm afraid you have me at a disadvantage, Lady...
Mira.
Lady Mira. I'm not used to being approached so boldly. But I'm glad you did. I always feel a bit out of place at big gatherings like this. So, what brings you over here? I'm not the best company, I'm afraid. Or were you headed for the wine and I got in your way?
You work with Lord Andros, right?
Well, yes. We do some business together.
What kind of business?
I really shouldn't talk about it. Andros came to me in confidence. You understand? He wouldn't be pleased, I'm sure.
If you like, you can whisper it in my ear.
I suppose I could just...
Lyman! What do you think you're doing?
What? Nothing.
You stay away from him.
Andros! We were just talking.
You were just talking to Mira Forrester.
Forrester? I didn't realize.
My lord?
Let me say this as plainly as I can. Don't ever meddle in my affairs again!
Lady Marjorie. Lady Marjorie.
Lady Mira? That was quite a scene over there. Are you all right?
I'm fine. I can handle Lord Andros.
It's Lyman I was worried about.
What do you mean?
Honestly, that story isn't fit for a maiden's ears. Just be careful around him. All right?
Don't tease me, Lord Tarwick. I'll keep your secret safe.
I suppose I could tell you. If you'll first tell me something about Sarah. Your help could save me a lot of embarrassment. I'd be very grateful, Lady Mira.
What do you want to know about Sarah?
Sarah Durwell. Interesting name, that. Funny thing is, the last Durwells died off almost 200 years ago. What can you tell me about her family? Something isn't quite right, but I'm not sure. You must understand, I can't court a woman just because I like the way she laughs.
I've met the Durwells when I was at Highgarden.
Oh?
They're a small house these days, but very well regarded.
Ah, right. Well, that's a relief. For a moment, I thought...
And now, Lord Tarwick, it's your turn.
Right. Lyman Lannister. 10 years ago, Lyman was injured at the tourney at Lannisport. He took a bad fall from his horse, needed milk of the poppy for weeks just to keep from screaming.
Oh.
And between us, he's never stopped drinking the stuff. Can't stop, actually. He spent all his money trying to get more. The man can't go a day without it.
So that's why he shakes?
You mustn't repeat that, Lady Mira. I shouldn't even know about it. Besides, Lyman suffered enough embarrassment. And every man's entitled to his secrets. He'd be horrified if everyone knew.
I won't tell. I promise.
Good. I'd hate for Lord Andros to trace this back to me.
You learned that from Andros?
The man's mouth is bigger than the Blackwater. Poor Lyman has no idea. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some arrangements to make. Lady Mira.
Lord Lyman, we really need to talk.
I know what you're up to. I won't discuss my business with Andros, so please, please, just leave me alone. You've landed me in enough trouble. Just leave.
Just be quiet, Lyman.
Either tell me what you want, or go bother someone else. I don't have to stand here and take this.
You've been drinking more than wine, Lord Lyman.
What? What do you...
I know about the milk of the poppy. And what happened at Lannisport.
No, you can't. No one can know.
If you want me to keep it quiet, tell me about Andros.
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath. But Andros is doing it in secret. No one knows. Or at least, he doesn't want anyone to know. I told him I'd keep quiet, but... well, now you know, too.
Lord Whitehill won't be slaughtering anybody.
With an army that size, he'll slaughter whoever he wants. But this is... there. You got what you wanted. But if you tell anyone what you heard about me, those sellswords won't be the only thing you have to worry about.
What did I tell you?
It doesn't matter anymore, Andros. She knows everything.
Lady Mira, you've just made a very grave error. Very grave indeed. You realize that, I hope.
As have you, my lord. Because I know everything you're planning. And I'm going to destroy you.
Sure you know where you're going?
Cotta?
Let's see that map again.
So you're asking now, are you? Surprised you haven't taken it from my pocket already.
How much food we got left?
Here we are.
Carried. How's the food?
This won't last much longer.
If Finn wasn't eating all of it.
It's not me.
I will have to stop soon. Look for some food. We're on the right track. This way. I'll try and talk to her. I'm one of them.
Wait, what? He's a fucking wildling, Cotta!
They might kick me around a little, but whatever you do, don't come out, all right? She has to think I'm alone. If she sees you, you'll only make things worse.
Good on, Ting. No, I'm a friend. I grew up near Ardholm. You know it? I won't hurt you, all right?
You won't.
I'm one of you.
You sure look like a crow to
me. Not.
You're dressed like one.
You out here all alone, little pup. Come out or I'll kill your friend. Or I'll make him scream first.
Listen, I don't want to fight.
He'll be all right. Won't he?
Stop! Please!
You don't like it! You best hope your little crow brothers come looking for you soon! How's that feel? I think you can do better than that!
Garrett!
Kill them!
Was running away.
We can't stay here.
You're hurt.
Come on. We can rest up ahead.
I'd feel better seeing Griff dragged out of the Great Hall like that. You wanted to kill him, didn't you? How did you know when to stop? I don't think I could have. I suppose that's why you're the Lord. And I'm...
I didn't know how to stop myself. Mother hadn't stepped in, I'd have killed him.
What do you think Lord Whitehill will do when he hears?
He won't know of this. Not until we want him to. The gates are barred and every raven in the rookery is dead.
My lord, there's been a message from High Point. Lord Whitehill invites you to discuss a truce.
He wants to make peace.
As if we're that naive.
Maybe this is an opportunity, a way to get behind their walls.
And do what? You'd be putting yourself in danger, Roderick.
She's right. What do you hope to accomplish?
We could get Ryan back. This could be our chance.
You're right. Now that we have Griff, we can propose a trade.
A trade?
His son for my brother.
Then we have a plan. We'll leave first thing tomorrow morning.
If you're going ahead with this, at least bring the Glenmore soldiers.
We obviously need them here.
You can't mean for Roderick to travel unprotected.
What if the Whitehills attack Ironwrath while he's gone?
My lord, you cannot go into an enemy stronghold unprotected.
Nor can you leave Ironwrath vulnerable.
Ironwrath is ours again. The Glenmores will ensure it stays that way.
Let Arthur know at once.
Yes, my lord.
I'll start making the preparations.
Well, I'll need an advisor with me at High Point.
By rights, it should be your sentinel. But for something this delicate, perhaps you'd best take Duncan.
You're going to an enemy stronghold. Surely you want your master at arms.
It's Roderick who must decide. Who would you rather have by your side?
Royland's my sentinel. He comes to High Point. Duncan can stay here and defend Ironwrath.
Very well.
Roderick, I know I can't come to High Point, but I can't just sit around and do nothing. I want to help. Please. I'll do anything you ask of me, even something dangerous. I don't care.
Talia, you'll be the only forester at Ironwrath while we're gone. I need you to rule in my stead.
I'll do my best.
I have faith in you, Talia. Ethan rose to this task, and so will you. I've known Lud Whitehill a long time. He's selfish, greedy, and arrogant. But he'd never kill a guest in his own home. At least, I don't think he would.
I hope you're right, Mother.
Welcome.
Don't worry about me. Focus on the mission. Your family needs you. That's what matters right now.
Who said I was worried about you?
Good luck, my boy.
Shall we begin?
Listen up! There are four of these guard posts throughout the city. They'll use them to warn the masters in case the slaves decide they're tired of wearing chains. We're here to make sure they don't see it coming. Therand, You take the north, Penn the south. Asher will take the east. And Kieran will cover the west. Make the enemy blind. Give the Unsullied a chance to get in and arm the slaves. The rest is up to them. Don't get cocky out there. One mistake and the man
you remember when we stole that giant warhammer?
Get in, do
from
what
that
you have
woman
to do,
in Lees?
And get your people
didn't
out
she hit
alive.
You in the face with it?
That's all you
I
need
never
to
thought
care
my
about.
Head could feel any
you
worse.
You got that.
Tonight, any man who wishes to be free may take that freedom from the grip of his master. You will clear a path for them, but they must walk it alone. Justice belongs to the people of Meereen. Do not make them wait any longer.
What does she know of justice?
Is there a problem? If you can't do this, tell me now. The Masters will be judged by the people of Meereen, not by you.
You don't have to worry about us. Just point us at the people you want dead, we'll take it from there.
You enjoy this far more than you should. Kill only those you must. You will both do as Croft commands. Follow his orders exactly, or you will get nothing. Now go. Show them the hell they have made here.
Hoped I'd never see this place again. Tried to run once. Didn't make it very far.
Which way?
There's a path around there. Avoids the main street. Let's just get this over with. What's the matter, Croft?
You see how many guards are out there? How were you expecting to get past them? We'll be caught.
You asked me which way. This is it.
Then we'll stay out of sight. Follow me.
Can you see anyone?
Cover me.
Oh. Been used recently.
What are they doing?
Hey, Pesca!
Pesca!
Yalwa Misha, my Esli was. Shall she
Skuda juntas wa.
Yelwa Misha, Maya's liwash. Shall she liwash?
Spalsa washka.
Maesli was.
We have to go.
There's something I have to do.
Beska, what are you doing?
Do you trust me, Asha?
We don't have time for this.
Just tell me. Do you trust me?
Of course I trust you.
Good. This won't take long.
Beska!
Where are you going?
Follow her!
Ingidratuli, Sewas was Lee on Yiha.
Why are you doing this?
10 years ago!
Beska! No!
I should have killed you!
Beska!
I should have fucking killed you!
Beska!
He was my master. Desor Zoraza. The man who forced me to... I'm going to kill you! That is a mercy compared to what you deserve.
Nobody can blame you for wanting him dead. Do what you must.
I will.
Have you lost your mind? I'm ordering you to back away!
My best guy!
I am not your...
Let him go!
What are you doing?
I shoot! You will do as I say! Both of you, take her weapon!
I need to do this, Asha. After everything he's done.
And he'll pay for it. Once the city is free, he will be punished.
Punished by a queen who has no right to. His life means nothing to her. She does not speak for the children who died in those pits.
Asha, stop her!
I will get their justice.
I won't let you ruin this for me. You heard what Daenerys said.
Go ahead, Beska.
What have you done?
Let's go.
So when were you going to tell me he's a fucking wildling?
Not now, Finn. Come on.
What the hell is this place?
An old hunting camp. We can rest here.
Until your friends attack us again.
I know the signs, all right? It's abandoned.
Ah. I'm gonna go make sure nobody's lurking around out here. Don't trust this fucking place.
Fine. Here, let me take a look at it.
Ha! If you're not gonna help, just leave it alone.
Oh, you got anything to drink? This far north and I still have to fetch the fucking wine.
Some water or something, please.
I'll see what I can find.
You find any water?
Not yet.
Whoever was living here must have left. Too bad they didn't leave anything behind.
Still don't trust him, you know.
I know.
He nearly got us all killed. Fuck, maybe that's what he wanted to happen. Why else would he bring us here?
Hey, look. Just give Cotter a chance. He's not so bad.
I did give him a chance. And look where we are.
Someone's still living here. Oh, I've seen this before.
Don't move. I'm warning you. Or I'll gut you like a fucking fish. You do look like a sad little fish, don't you? That happened a lot. I can fix it for you.
I don't want to hurt you. Put your weapon down. Now.
Not likely, is it?
Step back! You want to kill her yourself, or should I do it?
Garrett!
Drop your weapon!
Is that...
Garrett!
You're outnumbered. You can't fight all of us.
Cotter!
Oh, Sylvie.
You're alive!
Who's this fucking Snowball?
I told you I'd come back.
Who are these people?
They're friends.
Right.
You planning on introducing us, Cotter?
Right. This is my sister, Sylvie. She's the reason I brought you here. She can take us to the North Grove.
Lord Roderick. Lady Alyssa.
Gwyn?
Roderick, may I have a word? Thank you for accepting my father's invitation. I wasn't certain you'd come, but it's a good thing you did.
Be honest with me.
If things get bloody, are you on my side or his?
My father honors Guestright, just as you do.
You didn't answer the question.
I wanted us to work together, but you refused. So now my father is doing this his way. If you value your life and your family, you'll listen to what he has to say. You need to take him seriously today, which means keeping a level head and thinking before you jump to conclusions. Tread carefully today.
There are lords who wield power, and lords who like to make a show of it.
These walls hold 1,000 years of Whitehill history.
1,000 years of bloodshed.
But our houses were close once, and could be again. So much of our history has been lost.
Shall we get on with it?
The Great Hall is this way.
Your soldiers seem on edge.
Well, what do you expect? The way they see it, the enemy is within their walls.
What's this?
M'lady?
Give us a moment.
Is this your family?
Shortly before Griff was born.
Are these your brothers?
The eldest three, yes. Carl died of grayscale a few years ago. Ebbett's at the Citadel. Torrin serves Roose Bolton. And Griff, of course, wasn't born yet.
That must be you.
A much younger me, yes.
You look a bit like your mother now. Your father doesn't smile much, does he?
He used to, when my mother was still alive.
Is that your mother?
Yes. Though I hardly remember her. She died not long after this was made. My brothers were never kind to Griff. He was boastful, gullible, and quick to anger. But my father always defended him. A Whitehill is a Whitehill, he'd say. Come on, we mustn't keep my father waiting.
Where's your father?
Strange. I'll go find him.
I don't like this.
Don't show fear. That's what he wants.
Ryan for Griff, that's still our plan.
I'll follow your lead, my lord.
Let's have a look around, see what we find. Why all this? If they mean to betray us.
Bread and salt would mean we're protected by Guestright.
He's testing us, seeing what we're made of.
What's Lord Whitehill planning?
Bloodshed, most likely. We won't go down without a fight.
Just follow my lead, whatever happens.
That's far enough.
From the other side.
Roderick! Welcome to High Point.
Lord,
my men say you've been acting a bit tense. You're not nervous, are you?
I could ask you the same thing. All these soldiers...
Sounds like you're feeling outnumbered.
Father, please. Can we just get on with this?
Well? Your father once called High Point a keep for the gods. What stonework, he said. What craftsmanship. He wouldn't stop talking about it. If you ask me, I'd say he was envious.
Hasn't aged well, though, has it?
Stone crumbles, but at least it doesn't burn.
Lud, where's Ryan?
Always worried about your family, aren't you? Let's toast to family! Won't you toast with me, Roderick? As a symbol of our goodwill.
To family.
To family.
Now, as lovely as this is, I presume we have business to discuss.
Indeed we do. The Ironwood business is thriving, Roderick. In fact, the Boltons want weapons faster than we can make them. And when Roos Bolton wants something, I like to give it to him.
You brought me here to discuss Ironwood.
I brought you here to discuss your family's future. You foresters are headed for destruction.
Yet...
you know more about Ironwood than any house in the realm. Would be a shame for all that knowledge to be lost. Help me craft Ironwood for the Boltons, and I'll make sure you foresters survive.
As if he'd protect us.
If you think you can threaten
us... I'm not threatening.
So you're proposing an alliance?
An alliance? I said nothing of the sort.
He'd make us his slaves.
Roderick, this could save your house.
I'd consider an alliance.
You see what I have to put up with.
Just give him time. I told you...
I offer you peace, and you spit at it. I offer opportunity, and you demand more. I've seen this coming since you refused to kiss my ring. Here's how it's gonna go, Roderick. Either you agree to my terms, or I'll have Griff tear Ironwrath to the ground. He'll put it to the torch!
This isn't the way to get what you want!
Then begin slaughtering your small folk!
Griff's no longer in charge of Ironwrath.
What are you talking about?
He's locked in our darkest cellar along with your entire fucking garrison.
You didn't.
You've imprisoned my son. He was there by order of the Warden of the North!
Roderick, how could you?
Now it's my turn to propose a deal. Your son Griff for my brother Ryan.
We want Ryan back, and we want him today.
Bring the boy!
Ryan! Mother! Roderick!
I thought you'd forgotten about me.
No!
No!
What are you doing?
You imprisoned my flesh and blood.
Mine!
Let him go!
He's not going anywhere!
Listen to her! Don't
I swear by
this.
The gods if you will...
Let him go! Or I'll have Griff
killed!
This
is not what we agreed.
Blame him! Not me!
If you want to see Griff alive again...
You think I give two shits about Griff? About my fucking fourthborn? Come on! I ought to kill you right now! Because you foresters never learn!
I'm not afraid of you!
Can I fucking murder him yet? Try it!
Ryan!
Hold on!
Let go of me!
Let him go!
Everyone, please!
I'll kill you myself!
I want to do something!
Now, Roiland! If you want to see Griff alive,
you think
again,
I give two shits about Griff? About my fucking fourthborn? I ought to kill you right now!
Because you foresters never learn!
I'm not afraid of you!
Can I fucking murder him yet? Try it!
Why don't you
hold
me?
Let him go!
Everyone, please!
Go on then! Do it!
What?
You think I won't?
I know you won't!
Don't test him, Roderick!
Just for all your bluster, all your posturing, you care about your son. Whitey is still a Whitey.
You know what, Roderick? You're right.
Ryan, come here.
No! We'll make the trade on neutral soil. Griff for Ryan. A son for a son.
Fine.
Now, get the fuck out of my hall. And the gods have mercy on us both when the Boltons come for their ironwood. Now go.
It's been a pleasure, Lord.
I'm so sorry, Roderick.
Iron from ice!
There it is. The East Watcher.
Now listen up. None of those guards can live long enough to light that beacon. Because if they do, this invasion gets a whole lot fucking harder. Don't drop that.
We'll need to take those two out first. How many men do you think are in there?
Hard to know for sure. At least five, maybe more. To answer your question, too many to fight head on.
So we do this quietly?
Unless you want 50 crossbow bolts in your chest.
Is that a harpy?
Course it is. Those golden tits are everywhere in this bloody city. If those guards light the rope, the fire travels up to the bowl, and the whole city will know we're here.
So we stop them.
Aye.
Come on, let's get moving. Beskar.
It's nothing. Just forget it.
Is it D'Zor?
He's dead. You gave him what he deserved. Time to move on.
Not him I'm worried about. It's Croft.
hope he doesn't. It's done now.
I'll take him.
I've got the other one.
Just keep an eye on her.
I don't need him to watch me.
Then prove it!
What have you heard?
Just sit outside the gates waiting.
Mother of dragons. She wants to scare us, but she won't do it. Not unless she's a fool.
We'll split up. One group will go high and try to climb over to the other side.
What about them?
That's why someone needs to stay down here. They get behind cover and shoot the men up top. Just don't let that one see you. So, which will it be?
We'll go over the top. You just make sure you clear the way.
Hear that?
This Khaleesi calls herself the Breaker of Chains.
I think Croft got the easy job.
On the roof.
We'll take care of it.
I'll get rid of them.
Got it. Go.
I know what I'm doing.
Doesn't look like you do.
Little rat.
You say something? Well?
I said you're a little rat. Why are you laughing?
Nothing. Just keep doing it, Emma. Tell me when your sword breaks.
It won't break. You will have to first see how you like it.
All clear down there? Hey!
They're still up there. On the right. Take them out, and you'll be clear to secure the beacon. They break through. I'll keep them busy.
We can finish this. Just look at them. Two men. We've dealt with worse. Let's rush them and be done with it.
What about them?
You afraid of a couple of crossbows? We took on the Lost Legion by ourselves.
We stick to Croft's plan. Take care of them first.
All right.
Believe you did it.
Croft!
Croft!
Quit your whimpering. I'm not dead yet.
Hear that?
It's starting.
Home at last. Back at High Point, I wasn't sure your brother would survive the day.
He nearly didn't.
I was terrified when you called Lud's bluff, but you knew exactly what you were doing. And now Ryan will be coming home. He'll sleep in his bed, eat at our table. He'll be right here, where he belongs.
Restoring our family is just the beginning. Next we'll rebuild. Make ourselves strong again.
Oh, Roderick, sometimes you sound just like your father.
My lord, look.
Where are the gods?
Dahlia? Duncan?
Where are the Glenmores?
Where's anybody?
Wait here.
Come on. Don't be so dreary. It was a joke.
I'm sorry, I should have laughed.
Or maybe you think you can do better.
Of course not. I didn't mean to offend
you. Perhaps a song instead. I hear you've written a touching song about your dead brother. Am I in it? Let's hear it, shall we?
No.
No?
Roderick!
Roderick! Welcome back.
Get away from my sister.
But we're having such a nice time. Aren't we, Talia? Say it. Say it's been lovely.
It's been lovely.
And you? I'm told you're a man who can't be broken. I've decided to come see for myself. Ethan was the first forester I killed. Doesn't have to be the last.
You don't know what you're in for, Garrod. What you're asking my brother to do. The North Grove isn't what you think it is.
Justice was for Maureen to deliver, not you.
But we did as you commanded!
These aren't sellswords, Asher. They're killers.
Roderick!
I can't believe I trusted him.
I know you and my brother were in contact. Perhaps he told you things. Things that might prove his guilt. Perhaps you're not to be trusted either.
Oh, you're not listening, Garrod.
Shh!